Hi, John here. Today is Monday the 30th of October 2016. 31st of October 2016. I'm just about to ring Sue Nikora in Gisborne. She rang me up and wanted to give an update on what's happening up at Waitangi. And so I wanted to let her know my intentions and that of the Whakameninga, where it's going to, because she didn't attend the last bit of it. So here goes. Yeah, Joe, is Sue ready to call me yet or not? John Wanoa. Okay. Kia ora, I was just wanting to call you because I'm going to the gym and I didn't know when you was going to ring, so I thought I'd ring you up. Oh yeah, what's that? What is that? What does that mean? Respite? Oh, I see. Oh, I see. Okay. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, okay. So the indifference there with Kingi was that someone stopped me going into the Marae and taking the Confederation and the Whakameninga in there. And yeah. Oh, okay. So, So all I was doing, see, everything that happens in the Waitangi Marae, I'm organising. I've organised it for the Whakameninga. And to take to Britain, for me to go to Britain, it's nothing to do with what you do, and nothing to do with anybody else but King William. Yeah, now they, it's always like that, they jump up and down. See, they disrupted my presentation. I never got to do what I wanted to do. So it's all on video now, and the whole world's watching and saying, what's wrong with your native people, John? They just missed the mark. You see, So I'm only looking at the trust, the Queen Victoria Trust, that Kingi is direct to it. See, he's got a claim straight into that, but he doesn't know it. I'm telling him what is there. So I'm only dealing with the Navy's title. That's the Crown title. It's the Navy put it there. Nobody's got documents of that. I've got those things. Yeah, I know. I'm always expecting that all the time, but as long as, you see, they told me to cut all the stuff out of my videos, and it means I might as well cut the whole lot out. And then the taumata said, no, that's all right for you to film in there, you see, because I'm telling them the story of where they should be. That's the reason why, it's because he's not telling anybody. See, he gave me the authority to go ahead and film. The other ones didn't, you know, I didn't ask for permission to film in the Marae. Then I said, no, Kingi said, go ahead. So because he's the oldest, you see, he takes command of being the oldest, but they sacked him off the taumata, you see. They've sacked him off the taumata, and now the heiheis took over. See, the heiheis are there all the time, and he's outnumbered. The Whakameninga did that. See, that now the Whakameninga is running without Kingi. Yeah, no, he didn't want to. He didn't want you reciting, making him recite in front of him. It makes him put him down in front of his people. Because he had a bite out of me and Tracy. And then Tracy left them on the road when she came back. That's what it came out to. He was upset more so with you coming out, and that's why he probably locked the gate out from going on to the marae on the other side, because him and I set that up. He set it up with me because I was telling him what to do. So now that's an action in Westminster. What we did on the 15th inside that marae is gone to Westminster. Georgie was there to see it. She couldn't understand what I was doing there. The Crown can't stop me doing what I'm doing because I'm holding the Admiralty's title. Yeah, I know, but that's not your land. The thing is this, the overriding title with the names on it doesn't match up. I've got the titles here, Mohi gave me them, and it shows who's who. So the male made the deal with the Crown captain on the ship. Yeah, so that's okay. Yes, so that's all in the Crown, John Key, your side to sort out. See, that's got nothing to do with the marae on the other side of Britain. That's got nothing. The overriding title is the Crown, Westminster title, is on the other side. That's what John Key's getting away with. You see? Yeah, I know that, but the thing is that... Yeah, I know. Yeah, so that's fine, because that you're dealing with the land here. You're dealing with the land here, but I'm dealing with the trust in Britain. I'm going with that 99% of the deal. You've only got 1% of the deal here, and Nga Puhi, Tracy's just told me they're going to settle with two. Yeah, no, the contracts, what they sign with the Crown here, John Key, is on the land here. Yeah, but he's got control here. Because the British government let him. Yeah, I'm not going to let anybody speak on the 6th of February inside that Waitangi Marae. It's going to be just the flag to whop the whole lot out. So. They're limited to what they can say or do, because at the end of the day, the Crown's got the money to pay anybody out. And they'll either say, if you don't come to the party, we won't pay you. And that's the end. They signed the contract. Yeah, so you have to... Yes. So all of that, what you're doing, is in the Titi Marae. It's in the Titi Marae, but not on the other side. Yeah, so that's a new, that's all it, that's all. Yeah, so that's in New Zealand dollars. I'm talking about pound notes on the other side. I'm talking about Paunos, and no one's going to talk in that marae on the other side to John Key, but the native court, which is they've got their native judge, and I don't want to tell anybody who it is that's going to be doing that over there. The other side in the Waitangi Marae is not Maori. It's a Moai origine native. There's no Maori mention on what I do to Britain because they don't have Maori on their titles over there. That's been made up over here on this land. See? No, they wrote it that way so that every claim's got to pick what they write, what they put. There was no Maoris in 1834 when the first British sailor got off the ship and said the land belongs to the king. I'm going on that title, and the Mohi Manukau took over, his titles took over in Auckland when they shifted the government. The first British government at Kororareka blew it out to pieces and then shifted to Auckland. That's the title that I'm going on. It had no Maoris in it. It's on the original titles. Originally native, no Maoris. I've already got it set up in Britain, in Westminster. I've already told them in Waitangi, they've got blockheads up there. They can't understand what that flag is. That flag, the chief's got around in a circle in Ngaere, up at Matari Bay. They got around in a circle. Only the chiefs got around. When I put the flag up with Jim Waikato on the treaty grounds on 6th of February, straight after that. See, I'm putting the flag up, I meant to put it up on the 20th. On that day, I went and had it all arranged to open the marae up on the other side to go and put the flag up, and that would have been the end of John Key. Before... Yeah, I'm going to do it on Waitangi Day now because I'm heading off the nuclear ship coming from the US with the martial law, and this country be stuffed next month. There will be stuff because the Queen's coming back through the back door to bring the martial law here. There's nothing anybody can do about it.
Did you know that they've already changed the day of the
Waitangi Day? Yeah, they're shifting it over to that marae on the other side. That's why I'm heading in there to go and get it off them. It's sitting on Kingi's land. We only go like this. This is how British title works. When they put their ship on the land, that's the land that's got the title. Nobody else's business. It's private. Yeah, no, well, I'm going only on the historic day of their Treaty of Waitangi Agreement on that. What's written on that obelisk outside Te Ti Marae, that's John Key's title to this land. I'm only going on that memorial. With land titles, with native land titles, you have to have a memorial and the names of chief and the British who gave the authority. Yeah. No, I don't have to. I don't know if it'll be fixed up from the other end. I'm acting king. I'm acting surrogate king. At Britain and America is believing me now online. They know the flag's going to save them their countries. And now Clinton's going to get locked up now because he's caught. Right? And John Key's going to get caught with Clinton and Trump goes in to take over and I go there with the flag. The flag is where it went around the world. I'm not bothered about what it did here. I'm worried about where it went and with the world with the Queen. Yeah, that's my business, going around the world with the 99% of the trust funds. Not here with 1%, less than 1%. I'm not going to settle for that. Everything that's in New Zealand dollars is corrupted. I won't touch anything that got the word Maori on it because they've corrupted the Maori. They created the word Maori. It's their patent. It's their, if you got the things with the word Maori, that's what I'm warning the Whakameninga. Don't put Maori on your documents. Because they created it in the war times, the Boer War and that in 1945. Yeah, so they own the Maori Land Court, they own the Maori Tribunal, they own everything with the word Maori on their documents. That's why I stick to the document of the British on that Heihei's Rehia land. Those two ships, the one at Kororareka. No, she's come and apologised. She apologised to me and Johnny Boy, apologised to me in front of everybody for getting on the wrong side of the world. So when I said I'm doing Mohi Manukau's, when I said I'm doing Mohi Manukau's history, it's correct. And then they apologised for me for giving me a hard time. Mohi Manukau and Hare Otatanga. Yeah, so I'm doing their story, not mine. I haven't said anything about my own things, and I'm just putting memorial with chief name, and that's all I can do. All I can do is put that in place and let them go for it, and stand there and watch. And that's what I was basically doing, just stand there and watch. I'm doing my case because they're the partner that put let John Key get away with without no checks and balances. There's no one checking John Key. And the British are liable. That's what Paul Moon said, that historian guy. He said, the British are liable for what happens here. So you go back to the British. I take the mandate from the Whakameninga. I take it. They send me to England, not me. I can't go there on my own without their say and take the flag there and put it up. So the flag... Yeah, that's... Yeah, so it... Yeah. They got caught up. Yeah, he's got caught up. Yeah. So they've got caught up in mischief with finance, trying to get it in the country. And Johnny Boy, the boy that plays the guitar with the long hair, that's his brother. He apologized in front of everybody and says, I'm sorry, John Ronald. I'm sorry for talking about you like that. It's when I got up and said, I'm talking about Mohi's story, not me. I'm telling you what's good for you. And so I said to Kingy, you have to have a government. So then I said, no, Sue, that's Sue's place, you see. But when it blew out, then he got the wrong expression. He thought me and Tracy and you are ganging up on him. Yeah. So he suddenly saw, he's come from nowhere and picked. He's come from nowhere and picked up Mohi's papers because I saw his stamp on it, and Mohi put that together. And there goes, because he was there at the meetings with us at Del Hiongi's place, but he didn't have much to say because Dan Davis and the rest were big mouths were going to town, eh? Oh no, he's still the Whakameninga still got to look at all sides. They're gonna have to put you in because you've got an established government. But the thing is, they had to get their house in order first before they get the government in. You see, now that they got the Whakameninga set up, they sort themselves out where they're going to. Yeah, so they... Yeah, so now they're following their process of the best way they can, and I'm just looking at how they're putting themselves together from after 182 years from Kororareka, that they're trying to construct something out of limited knowledge. Yeah, you see? Now, half of the leg is in the paddock. They say, why is those people in the paddock? Why didn't they come in the marae? All the rangatiras with the knowledge is in their tents. And they won't give it up to the taumata because the taumata ignores them when they come in all the time. Yeah, I know. Yeah, I know where you fit because you have all the right in the world when they get sorted, because but they didn't like being told, you know, from a kick point start of trying to make something out of rubble work in the taumata, because the taumata split up with Kingi going one way and he pops in and pops out, and they don't like popping in and popping out. Yeah. So that's their fashion. That's the mentality. That's how they work in their heads. They haven't. They're not following instructions from a book. They're just picking it off from remnants of the past. Yeah. So, but anyway, out of all the confusion, they managed to make an agreement of some sort. You know, I my name is not on it because they didn't approach me to put my name on. And I'm saying, oh no, I talk for the king. I don't need to do that. Yeah. Yeah, so that has to fit in. You have to fit in at the right time when they feel like they're getting somewhere. It's like a ship without a captain. It got no engine running, only half done. They're still trying to crank the thing up and it won't go. Yeah, so that's where it is. And I've got to go back up to Kaikaui, to Pangaru, and give up another presentation, fill my car with gas, and go back up there again. Tell them exactly what I wanted to say on the marae I never got to say. I never finished off my presentation because Hohepa got on his feet, but he's okay. But when you stand on your feet, nobody talks. That's tikanga. But well, when you got a coordinator like him, he's got to keep the peace on the, between one and the other. You see, because there's too many factions saying one thing and another saying another, and trying to cross paths with their territory boundary. And over the same space, and then the tribunal says, no, you put it in one place. See that girl, Tangaire, she's the president of the Waitangi tribunal. What's her name? Tangaire. Yeah, well, her I think it's her brother or cousin, is Manahi. So Manahi is driving the Whakameninga now. I might as well tell you, he's the native court judge. That's going to be talking and put the order extinguishing the occupation titles inside that marae on the other side to Britain in an order. He give order to me to take to Britain as a sheriff. Yeah, so they said to me, don't publish too much, and I said, well, the whole world knows more than the natives here. They said, what's wrong with all your natives, John? Why aren't they saying, why aren't they doing what you say? I said, well, it takes a few years for them to understand it. Because it's commerce, banking, and all the rest of things the flag is meant for. And I just tell them, I'll be over to America to save you with this flag, because it's a king's flag. We're right back to King George III. Yeah. I've got a political party over there ready to go in Westminster. Just me, nobody. I don't need anybody. I just go there, put the flag up. I'm going there to put the flag up, and that's all I have to do. Put the flag up over there, so it'll go around the whole world and all the countries, and then come back and tell the tomato, oh, I got the flag up now. Now where you go? I'm going there to put to. I've legalized the power note on the 15th when we went in with Georgie. I went in there, legalised everything I want to do here, and the Acts of King William, 1832, 1837, no other acts. I'm using those acts in the Constitution back right there. No, she's changed her mind. But she is the Patrick name, is the 8-point star on our flag, St. Patrick's Order Church. She's the name Patrick is that bloodline to that New World Order the Pope is using. So that's why her name's beside me for that part of the flag. For that reason only. For that reason, the surname here goes with the surname in Dublin where the St. Patrick's Order. We were going there to and I'm going to Glasgow to check the Manukau land titles. See? What happened is when they set up the government, the parliament in Kororareka, when Honeheke cut the flag down, they blew the whole place to bits. That these are those ships that were there, the British ship, blew it and took it to Auckland. That's when they put the Manukau titles in and confiscated all the rest of the titles and reissued them from straight from Britain, right? That's part I'm doing. That's what Mohi was trying to tell them. But no, I'm telling Mohi's story as though he's standing there trying to tell them. That's how it works in the British, from the British end, you see? And all the commerce is on the other end. It's up to us to go there to tell the British where's our part of the 99% that you've taken, the Queen has taken, and left us with less than 1% here to settle. So when they settle the treaty settlements, it's only this government here doing it, not Britain. You see? So I've got to go there and tell the British, order the British over there to tell John Key, pull the plug on what he's doing. Then that'll be done on the 6th of February, and when he comes into that courthouse, then yeah, well, what'll happen is, the historic date on the 6th is the British day of their obelisk. We will have the meeting, that'll be good then, we'll have the meeting on that day, inside that whare, and then on the 8th when John Key comes in there, because he's got to go in there to take his authority, because that's where the Queen runs her business, inside that whare, with that ship outside. They're getting their authority from our flag, that's why it's on the crossbar as the partner to Britain, you see. Yeah. So the chiefs have to stand there and proclaim that the chiefs own the land and not the king or the queen. And when you say that in front of them, in front of their face, then that's the end of them. That's what I said, the proclamation I said takes 5 minutes to say that. Yeah, that's all I say in English. And then the chiefs, Kingi and them had it all ready to go. I told Jim Wikotu and Kingi what to say and say what I'm saying in English in Maori. Yeah, and that's all my job was, just to say that and no more. I never got to say that in the Titi Marae because Hoepa said 1 minute left after he was telling me, well, you got permission to film in here. And Kingi gave me permission to film in there, and in the end they let me film. Yeah, well, I got a complaint to the British High Commission because I put a notice to them to put it on the record that we're going in there to put the flag up on 182 years in Kororareka and 181 years in New Zealand to put the flag up to commemorate, and they should be there, but they didn't turn up. Officially, I got the letters. Now, with the shareholders, it's just the commercial part of business. Yeah, that's the commercial part of the flag. That's the commercial side. That's a trading flag for shareholding and all the rest of it. Yeah, I know, but they are got control of all the rest of the trustees in this country. Yeah, I know, but that's why no one has got the British told the British to tell John to button up. No one has ever approached the British government to tell John Key he can't do that. Yeah, so that's the only reason why, to put it into perspective of who's running this place. So you still had to have a government. So if you had a government, he'd be gone. But the thing is, it's not there yet. That's what I'm saying. It hasn't got an organisation to show that it's there operating with the people, the whole lot of the people, not just Maori, the whole lot of the people in the country. Yeah, so that's got to be put down. It's got to be put down in front of the country, and but the thing is this: they're over. Yeah, so I saw that, but it never got in front of the Whakameninga on that floor, inside that whare, And so, eh? Yeah, but it's outside and not inside. The whare, that's what the taumata are the landowners. They are the legal landowners. Yeah, they are the legal landowners, those hei fellas. No, I'm talking about them standing there as a taumata inside the... Yeah, I know, but the chiefs, I'm only going on what those chiefs are saying. I'm only writing this up for them of what they do inside that marae. And I said it off to Britain. Yeah, I know, but the thing is, at the end of it, that's why things are laughing stock. Marriage is a laughing stock in front of Jonki on the other side of the marae that's got the power. The power is inside that marae on the other side. Did you know that Waitangi marae controls the whole world? Nobody knows that, only me and Mohi Manuka. That's why Ilu went to Prince Peter in Malta and to the Vatican. He got mixed up in the Vatican. And that's the title I'm talking about. And I've got it all here that Mohi gave to me, and nobody knows. You see, I'm stitching the other end together. Hmm. Yeah, no, I've slotted you in for the Maori government because it has its place. And it's up to these whakameninga to absorb that, but they're going to take time to fit it in before the 6th of February or the 8th of February. Yeah, I know, but you're not a man. A man has to do... When they were at Ngaere, it was only men chiefs there that made this flag. I'm talking about the flag. It was only the chiefs that made the flag to Britain. The flag to Britain. That's all I talked to. Just that little group there of chiefs from the northern tribes put that and got the consent from the king. And they didn't design the flag. They chose it. Yeah. That kicked off the contract. That is the mortgage lien. All the admiralty titles in the world are mortgage liens. As soon as the captain on that ship gets off his ship, he's a surrogate king, and he says that the land belongs to the king. That's what I'm saying in reverse as a sheriff, the same thing as the captain on a ship, saying the same thing from a native contract. We are in private contract with the King William IV, and it's not cut. It's still going. Even though it's not doing anything, it can liven up any time. So that's all I'm doing, nothing else, just that, to connect us back up to that date, 20th of March, 1834. Not 1835, 1834 splits out all the confusion in the 1835 part of the flag that got mixed up with John Key's government, right? Yeah. They usurped it to make their 1840 treaty out of that 1835. But when you go back to the first ship that was legally here from Britain with King William's authority, that's the one I'm going on. That's the one those taumatas are. I'm schooling up the taumatas. Okay. But your government, your Maori government, is on the list as being an authorised, established government. I'm trying to tell them, put them in their thick heads, okay? Okay. Bye-bye. Right. Well, there you go. That's Sue Nikora. Sometimes I talk rough to her, but I don't really mean it. It just means that the stuff I got is far advanced of any other way of putting it. It's a British story, and those first native chiefs at Ngaere, Tangaere, that sat around under the Pohutukawa tree and picked the flag out, the Confederation flag, to get protection from the King of England. That's all. They don't understand that's the overriding title that Mohi Manukau was trying to tell them. That, hey, listen to me, John, don't listen to those other ones. And fair enough, I listen to all of them. I listen to all those people, Dawi Hungi, Machi Tarawa, and each one of them said, don't listen to that fella, don't listen to that fella, Mohi Manukau. I ended up getting everything I could possibly get from Mohi Manukau, because of Tira Waikato Wharaherehere, chief of Mangatauteri, went to England and learnt English and put these things together over there. So I've got to go there and connect that story on that end with this chief and Hongi Hika on that end and tell it from that end to this end. Pick up and keep going. Otherwise, if there's nobody on the other end, then it can't function from that end to this end. They've got to go from Australia to John Key, the long way around. And that's where you pick up all the fraud and the corruption. That way, you go direct, you get straight from the horse's mouth. You see? But I'm there to get the Queen replaced from our trust, the Queen Victoria Trust, and put King Ernest Augustus the Fifth in. Right? That's what I had to do, is make those intentions before the 6th of February. Now she tells me the Waitangi Day is changed to the 8th of February. What the hell's John Key up to? You see? They're changing, trying to change history in 5 minutes. He's trying to change the flag, the New Zealand Union Jack flag, and put a fern football flag up, and that didn't work. Now he's trying to change the day to the 8th, and that's not going to work. You see? So there's like a shifting sands, like dreams that don't come true. Fiction and stuff that won't stand up in court. So I'm just telling her we're setting up the Waitangi Marae this time for a court hearing that John Key's going to walk straight into in front of the chiefs, ready for him. Right? One way or the other, it's going to be the king or the queen. The queen's not there, so the king's there, still with a flag, a receipt of a contract, private contract with Admiralty title in it, straight to Britain, right in front of his eyes, and tell him, who are you? Where's your title? Where's your queen? Where's your seal? Where's your anything? Where's your authority? Who do you get it from? What is a vice admiral? Where does he get it from? You see, you're going to end up on King William IV and King George III, his father. You see, and skip over the top of Queen Victoria because it corrupted with the Rothschilds, corrupted the whole lot right through to Queen Elizabeth. All that lot with the queens there is corrupted the whole of the King's Bench Court. We're going into the King's Bench Court to audit the counts right through the world where the flag has gone with Queen Elizabeth II and duped everybody out, okay, and including Hillary Clinton and Obama, that she's given this financial martial law to hijack everybody and hold them up and take their guns off and all their money and their assets. That's what they, pirates, the flag we got of King William IV was made for pirates who get in the way of our business between here and England and Westminster and the British military, our partners, okay, our legal partners. Now, what I'm trying to tell Sue, she's on about the treaty claims. I've got nothing to do with the treaty claims. That's New Zealand dollars, so it's worthless. Worthless paper it's written on, not worth the paper it's written on, the Treaty of Waitangi, no end date on its contract, right? With the King, we can say anything we want because it's private. The Queen used the King's private contract so that you can't get to her, you see? We'll take it off her. We'll remove it from her and all the powers of in the Commonwealth countries, including America, of the ability to use King William IV and King George III's Admiralty Court Martial titles. Okay? So that's the aim of that law. Somebody's trying to get a hold of me on the line. So that's all. I'll just talk to Sue and make up things with her. I know she has got a long standing in what she does with the Whakameninga. So when she says she's the Whakameninga, it needs to be said in front of the Whakameninga men, right? You've got women and you've got men. The woman can't tell a man what to do. That's what Kingi didn't like. He didn't like reciting in front of her as if she's a chief. She was not a chief. The male chief that sat under the tree, I told her, it's a male that put that flag together. If anybody's playing around with that flag, they have no authority to use it, they're in trouble. They're in trouble. Even women have a right to use it for other reasons other than trade and investment and war. This flag is for war when I'm talking about it because it is a pirate's flag to protect us with the British military from anyone getting in the way, including the New Zealand police, who's got in Mar Road on Cook Street and lost the case because of what I'm saying about the King has overruling authority over what they do. Okay, we have seals of Westminster on my head, right there. Okay, that New World Order here with King William's crown on the top and his horse. And he's sitting on his horse and his ship of admiralty in the background. You'll see these on my Facebook page, on YouTube, and Twitter, Google. Right? So that's the New World Order that we're claiming to be, right in front of the whole world. Okay? The 8-point star on our flag on the four corners of the earth. That's free passage through the world we still have in that private contract I'm trying to tell soon. Why anybody flies that flag around. I know that Paulina has got the Samoan version of the flag. She's right in saying on the spiritual side, okay, of what it means, the four corners of the earth. That's us in the Pacific. She's part of the Pacific and part of us in our fabric and society and families. She comes from up there in Ngaere, Tangaere, where the chiefs put the chose that flag and sat there and decided what to do with British King William the Fourth. Okay, so her husband there lives there in Tangaere itself, not far from the Fortitude tree. So she has all the history there, and the Manukau Turihu Patiparaihe Moriori story. I've got all that here as well that Mohi gave me. I'm going on Mohi's story, Mohi Temati Manukau the Fourth. So he's got a long line of whakapapa to these lands. And I've got him on video right back in most parts of the North Island down to Ratna. So all that Ratna history is there with him and on One Tree Hill here as the Manukau Land Company, Scottish Company title, British title. All right, that's why I'm going after the Cook Street, 77 Cook Street title, that one of the land blocks that's under that Manukau title, and the whole of Auckland, right to Cornwallis on the Manukau Heads, the Pupanga Pa, is the Manukau Tribesmen Pa site, the biggest tribe in this country at that time, okay? And Kapalita Jai, the Waikato chief, and Cambridge. Here is to Cambridge, England, is Tira, Waikato, Wharaherehere, Manukau, and son Rewharewha Manukau, that in the time of Kawhiru, Rewharewha Manukau was there at the same time as the Manukau in Waikato and Kaipara, Bay of Islands, and here in Auckland. Manukau Heads. Okay, so that Rewharewha Manukau Ngā Puhi was trying to get rid of with the British trying to rid him. And there's a story behind that, and also Tira Waikato Wharaherehere I won't talk about. A lot of the stuff I've got is nobody's business. I'm keeping and safekeeping for Manukau because it's tied in with the Vatican and the Malta Templars and the Queen herself in the St. John order, and but that's not including the St. Patrick's order. That's not in that lot. That's from Westminster, okay, under King William the Third, right? I've got it all in order. I've got everything in its place. And so far, just to bring you up to date, from Waitangi, Titi Marae, on the 28th of October 2016, for the record, that I'm going to write to the British High Commission here, Louise Exley, and make an official complaint about not being able to get onto Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court, to take our celebrations back to the flag that got everybody on this land in the first place, and that Admiralty ship on Waitangi Treaty Grounds. Right? Now Sue tells me the Waitangi Day is going to be on the 8th. What the hang is John Key up to? You see? And we're going in there on the 6th. It's the historic day, is the 6th of February, 2016, not the 8th. The memorial there, 1840 Treaty of Waitangi Memorial, is John Key's title on Te Timora. It should have been on the other side. Now, it won't go on this side because the ship is there as the title. The memorial to the land there is our business. That's our business with the hapu, indigenous, native chiefs, rangatira. Okay? That's what it says, rangatira, chiefs, and the rangatira. with the king, William IV. So that's as much as I want to say from that day till now, today, is that I'm going up to Hokianga, to Pangaru, to have a meeting with the Whakameninga itself, the men, I'm talking about, the chiefs and the taumata collective of the 38 marais. You watch this video, I'll be up there at the request of Willie Pater to do a presentation, a full presentation of what I'm just saying on this video. And most of the time, everything I'm saying here is a statement for the record of Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court. All right, so I'm teeing in with Manahi Tangaere, because I've known him for a long time in the courts, and he's the native court judge on the day we go into that marae. Okay, so we've got two judges, one from up there in Nga Puhi, and Manahi from where I come from on the Rangitukia land blocks at East Cape, and Waiapu. Okay, so he's my bloodline there to talk for me in Māori, and for me to talk in English, straight law, and connections to Britain and Westminster from Waitangi Marae. Okay, so that's going to happen. With Sue, well, that's her business with John Key and their treaty claims, because it's not going to cloud over what we do here. I'm telling her she can do her treaty claims or make her loans from somewhere, and not with me, with the pound note. And we've got our own pound note currency ready to go from Cook Street. Once I seize Cook Street, I can go and get it any time now. That's why I make this public. The police steps aside, clear of, out of the way, when I've got this held. Right? All the sheriffs in America watching these videos, your sheriffs in the county is under the King, William the IV, and King George the III, his father, authority to use this flag we have of King William the IV with the native, for the native chiefs of Navajo, and for the Dakota native, it's the same deal with every native in the world. The British government and the Queen has usurped our Aotea New Zealand native title for their consolidating titles of bigger countries than New Zealand. So their blueprint of their original Queen Victoria and Queen Elizabeth titles comes from the Waitangi Marae King's Bench Court, the highest court in the world, there, under monarchy, sovereign, Britain, UK, Westminster. Okay? That's to put it straight to you, and Daryl Payne and Rennie Powers in California, take note of this, that's real. That's why America has got financial martial law breathing down your neck with Obama getting the consent from the Queen while she's abandoned ship and gone to the EU Parliament and still usurping the King's Bench Court authority. All right? We're there in the King's Bench Court to pull the levy debtors out of the Queen's Bench Court and debtor them from the King's Bench Court to balance books or bring it up to date and bill anybody that's been violating our flag of jurisdiction of Admiralty, mortgage liens, and banks. Okay? So from that, I'm just putting Sue on notice that no one's going to speak inside the Waitangi Marae but those chiefs. because it's the chief's flag, not the woman's flag, this time. Okay? The woman can have the flag for spiritual things on the land here, but not in the world. Not in the rest of the world, it's on the other side, to the world. Okay? None of anybody's business here on New Zealand land. It's part of the Commonwealth countries that the Queen is operating with her head and her seal in, and the British Westminster government operating with the British military right through the world, with us as being one of part of 66 million acres of land the Queen says she owns. And my proclamation to you all was that the land here in New Zealand belongs to the chiefs, rangatira, and not the king or the queen. Right? So that's the way it's going to be. As once we get it sorted. I just wanted to see if I can find the proclamation to read it out to you while I'm on this video, at least. I'll read it out because it's not that long. I'll bring it up. So I might as well say it here in front of everybody. Just what I need to say in front of them at Waitangi. So I'll make it big so I can read it. Here, I'll start from the top. I'll say it here, okay, while I'm talking about this subject. Proclamation. In the name of His Majesty King William IV, King of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Ireland, and living blood inheritance successors in 2016, King Ernest Augustus V, heir to the throne, 68 years old. King of Britain, UK, Hanover, Aotea, New Zealand, World, New World Order. And his son, Prince Regent Ernest Augustus, 38 years old, heir to the throne. By Hoani Kahaki Wano, Sheriff Creditor, that's me, surrogate King William IV, as if I'm one of the captains on a ship that's just stepped off the land and proclaimed the land belongs to the king. Surrogate King William IV, to speak for the king. Okay? Maui Crown Native Land Commissioner, that's the title I'm taking up in front of the taumata, that's what I'm saying I am. Then he goes, Chief Hongi Hika for the Confederation of Chiefs Hapu Rangatira in Congress assembled at Waitangi. Chief Tira Waikato for Aotea, New Zealand, Pacific Islands, World, New World Order, Maui Crown Bank. Okay, those are the two different titles of the chiefs at 1820, when they went to England to 1833, in that period of time. They learned English language and combat and banks and land transaction documents. Whereas I assert His Majesty, King, Ruler, Legacy in Waitangi Marae, Native Court, to Chiefs Commander from His Majesty King William IV Admiralty Jurisdiction, through his principal agent of State of Colonies, James Busby, did assert on the grounds of discovery of Aotea, now in right of Hapu Sovereign Chiefs, Rangatira, the administration of their native lands over the southern islands of New Zealand, commonly called the Middle Island, and Stewart Island, and the island commonly called the Northern Island, transferred back to the Confederation of Chiefs Hapu under proclamations of their inherent continuity of unbroken sovereignty over their native lands to their commercial trading bank private contract business partner, His Majesty King William IV's successor, King Ernest Augustus V, and his successors, Prince Regent Ernest Augustus, under Salic law forbidding women succeeding to his British throne. Now therefore I, Hoani Kahaki Wānoa, Crown, Maui Crown, Native Land Commissioner of Aotea, New Zealand and Pacific Islands, do hereby proclaim and declare to all men that from and after the date of these presents on full sovereignty over these islands, our full sovereignty over these islands of Aotea, New Zealand, Ngā Atua E Wā Aotea Pacific World, New World Order 8-point star title, extending from 34 degrees 30 minutes to 47 degrees 10 minutes south latitude and between 166 degrees 5 minutes to 179 degrees of east longitude vests in Moai Crown under His Majesty King Ernest Augustus V and his son Prince Regent Ernest Augustus, nominated as King of Britain UK Military Protectorate by the Chiefs in Congress Assembled, forevermore given under my hand inside Waitangi Marae King's Bench Court House. Sworn this 28th day of October in the year of our Atua Lord God, in brackets, the Lord God is in brackets, the Atua is our spirit, 2016 at Waitangi Marae, Moai, King William IV, Federal State, Commonwealth Government of the World, New World Order, St. Patrick's Order, 8-point star flag, 2016. Signed, His Excellency, by His Excellency, Surrogate King, Moai Crown Secretary of State, Jamie Anna Marie Patrick, St. Patrick Order. Signed, her, and myself, God Save the King, Hawani Kaha Ki Wano, Moai Native Land Commissioner, Sheriff of Waitangi Marae Court, extended to all district courts. That's Kingi Taurua next, signed, Native Chief Commander, Kingi Taurua New Zealand Military, Waitangi Marae Landlord, Queen Victoria Trust. Okay, so that's taking part of that Queen Victoria Trust here on this land. Contract. Waitangi Marae, printed by Moai Crown King William IV Trust and Moai King William IV Party, New Zealand Pacific Property Rights to His Majesty King William IV, 1832-1837 Acts of Westminster Parliament, enforced law on the 15th to the 4th, 2016. Legal private contract with Moai Native Chiefs of Aotea, New Zealand and Pacific Islands, Native Land Titles Absolute to Moai Crown, New Zealand Pacific, World King William IV, Federal State, UK, New Zealand Dual Governments, set up in Kororareka to London, British Navy, Devonport, UK, Government Private Contract Partnership Business, with Chief Hongi, Hika and Chief Waikato, sold Kororareka Land, 23rd, 1834, Captain George Lambert, HM Alligator, 21-gun salute, at Mighty Hill, 10th of April, 1834, Flagstaff. There. That is the proclamation I set out to say in 5 minutes in front of the Congress Assembled. Now, because we didn't have a gate open, it's going to be said on 6th of February as a historic date in time, 2017. This proclamation will be read out, but I'm going to put it officially to the British High Commission and the British Secretary of Defence, Michael Fallon, our intentions for the nuclear ship coming into Auckland to stay of any enforced laws from America is forbidden in front of the Whakameninga on the arrival of that ship here in port. And John Key, Prime Minister, has no legal authority or legitimacy in his authority to grant any laws above the laws we have, I just mentioned, 1837. Laws of financial martial law and also the High Court of Admiralty court martial laws that we have already enforced inside the Waitangi Marae King's Bench Court on the 15th of April 2016 this year. That court is open for business already under the Whakameninga title, Chiefs, Rangatira. Okay, direct to King William IV. And King Ernest Augustus V, his successor, live and living in London, England, as our oath of office, monarch, sovereign. On his photo, and his 8-point star on his coat with King William's 8-point star matched up as our authority, and King William's crown anchor and his horse and ship of Admiralty seal and crown at the top of the 8-point star. Ruling authority right over the world. Okay, that's all I'm going to say. It's real. Better believe it. Because John Key is on notice from this video. John Key, Prime Minister of New Zealand, you are forbidden from letting that nuclear warship coming into New Zealand from Obama's administration and enforcing its martial laws in this country. You're forbidden from doing that. On the record of this video, that the Clinton administration is now under investigation, opened up again by the FBI, James Comey. Okay, and Trey Gowdy, the congressman and ex-prosecutor, is prosecuting at the moment. I'm watching. I'm watching there and watching Britain, and the reaction of the Clinton administration, fraud, corruption, and Obama and the Queen implicated in this fraud scam. Business going on, defrauding the people of the world, the people of New Zealand and America, Britain, Canada, Australia, India, Africa, and other Pacific Island countries, and other countries under the Commonwealth where the Queen has gone with our flag. Okay, so that's basically on the record. John Key, you're on record. You're on the record in the British Westminster Parliament through the Secretary of Defence, Michael Fallon. You'll get a letter from me again on what happened on the treaty grounds. Someone forbidden us or stopped us from going into that marae by right of our inheritance to that British flagship with our flag that goes on a cross run as a partner to Britain. Okay? There's a violation of our native court judges and Rangatira. Okay? We have that inherent right to go on that land that still belongs to the Ngāti Rahiri and Ngāti Kaua, Hapu chiefs. You haven't bought it out yet. And now I see that the Ngā Puhi chiefs in the Crown side of John Key is trying to settle for less. That's a contract. I'm going to hold them to it. All those treaty claims are going to, you're settled. When you're settled, you're settled. Your contract's ended, but you'll have no rights to this King's Bench Court with this flag under King William IV. You will have no rights to it. I'm making that point clear. You'll be in the debtor's side of the levy to the creditor. That's my position as the sheriff, registrar, that makes the bill out to you. To anybody that's settling on that side with illegal contracts under the 1840 Treaty of Waitangi Memorial that's standing outside the Te Marae, you get the bill. You'll get the bill on the power note. I'll just write on the amount that the Rangatira chiefs say and any other New Zealander here are supporting us and the Maui Crown, King William IV Trust, creditor. Okay? So it only need a letter to this organisation and our organisation in London set up in the company's house. The Maui Powerhouse Group Limited Company, corporate King's Company of King William IV Maui Crown Trust. Okay, so that's how things shape up with what I'm saying about John Key and his disordered government, disjointed government, unconstitutional government, no end date contract government of the 1840 treaty is illegal with no end date to its contract. and our contract with the king is limitless. It's private because we have the true admiralty court, and not vice admiral is second hand. Vice admiral is coming through the queen, through the back door. It's not the one that created these acts. Was King William the Fourth and King William the Third, the 8-point star, King William the Third, and the St. Patrick's Order, Dublin, Ireland, and Westminster. King William the Third reigned to King William the Fourth on our flag. Our flag is a receipt of a contract in the private with King William the Fourth in his commerce and all his inheritance and prized possessions. King of the Sea, King of the Revenue, King's Royal Revenue in the King's Bench Court. Okay, he's the King of Commerce, and he's the King of the Common People, under common law, and also the King's Law himself. And we add to that the Maori Law, L-O-R-E, of Spirit, that's been missing in everything. That's why we've got the Maori. I just want to tell the Whakameninga and Maori people watching this video that we have separated Maori on Te Tī Marae, that's Maori, from the Maui on the other side in the Waitangi Marae. It's the Maui. Right? Maui is Tahitian Native Pacific People Memorial. The statue Queen Victoria took to London, the first one she took off Easter Island. She was the first to steal the first memorial of Maui statue and take to England, right? And then, in her time, the Maui was stuck on Washington DC and New York. New York, King William the Fourth, before he became king in 1830, the years previous, he spent 50 years in the Navy before he became king. He spent most of his years in the Navy in New York, setting up the Stock Exchange, right? And that's British. The Stock Exchange is British. And so that's financial arm that he set up. Prince Andrew took over as ambassador to England to take that around the world with its fraudulent US dollar that's come out of the pound note. Okay? The Bank of England, the Rothschilds took over the Bank of England from the Pattersons, who put it together in 1694, and King William III passed that act, the Bank of England Act, 1694, and the Pound Note Act, 1694. Then King William enacted it in 1834, the Bank of England Act, 1834, and the Pound Note and Coin Gold Coin Act in 1834, and that's the acts I'm using for our use of the Pound Note, King Tawhito Pound Note, which came under Tira Waikato Wharaherehere, Manukau, in 1820, when he went to Cambridge, England, and came back to Cambridge in that Waikato region where the Mangatauteri Mountain is, Pa, is in Cambridge. So that title matches up with the pound note of King Tawhito, Waikato chief, at 1888 period. So it's taken a long time for him to get the authority, license to use the pound note from Britain to his native chiefs, native origine, okay, native origine. There was no marriage right up to 1945, war period. That's the only time the marriage came in, so that's why I'm saying separate the Maori and their claims, treaty claims, in Te Tī Marae, with that memorial outside to John Key, 1840, fraudulent, crooked, useless, treaty document to stake their claims for less than 1%. That's that. On the other side is 100% plus claim against the Crown Corporation here and the rest of the world. So I'm doing the rest of the world, or the four corners of the earth, of that part of the flag where it went to. Okay, with the Queens. The Queens have corrupted the good work of King William IV and undone the whole thing. We're going to stitch it back together, and the Whakameninga will nominate King Ernest Augustus on this page 4 of the proclamation. There's two proclamations that are both the same, but the first one I put together has got Kingi on it as the chief, and King Ernest Augustus and King William, those three, and the 15th of April 2016, where Kingi and Hoepa Epiha and Willie Pater and myself and the rest of the people went into that marae to enforce these acts and the power note and the flag, made it legal. We made it legal that day, and from there we take that into the Waitangi Marae again with the Confederation. This was the Whakameninga, that one, the 1834 part of the flag, and now we take the 1835 Declaration of Independence flag into the Waitangi Marae Whakameninga on that side. Okay, you got that? That's how it is. And on the other, the right hand side, I got me there as sheriff and creditor with King William IV's regalia and his coat of arms and his seals. His seals on my head, seal on the head, and seal on documents. Okay? And we've got the Michael Fallon, the Chief of Defence, Secretary of Defence, UK, British Government, Westminster. And then we've got the other man, Philip Jones, Rear Admiral of the Navy, as being our partners. These are our two partners, right there. And Ernest Augustus on the left side of that picture, and Kingi and myself in the paddock with the flag, talking on the land, Te Te. And the two chiefs below that, Hongi Hika, and beside him, on the right, Tira Waikato Wharaherehere. Right, the Waikato chief and the Nga Puhi chief, right? Those are the two there that I've said who they are. Tira Waikato Wharaherehere was responsible learnt his interest was in the banknotes and finance land transactions. That's where the Manukau Land Company came out of Scotland. And Hongi Hika was responsible for combat. That's for conquering lands, British style of conquering with documents to say the land belonged to the king. So they were really coming back from England after 10 years of learning English language and documents and the consequences of anybody not following what the king is saying. They came back, he came back with the muskets, a load of muskets, and dished them out to his chiefs to go and blast everybody out of the way. That's what the British wanted, everybody off the land. And so he was charged with doing that by the British, King William IV government. Okay? So there you go, that's all I want to say. I'll make this video cut off now, and I'll get on with my day. It's raining outside in Auckland today, it's quite warm, and I'm going up to the gym to do my exercise. Now I've got this stuff, triple action, to go with my exercise to make me look big and feel big and strong like a chief. But all in all, I just wanted to keep healthy so I can keep up with the chiefs up in Nga Puhi and Whakameninga to get them prepared mentally and armed with real live documents that stacks up to the British system of law, and not the law here with John Keyes using the colonial law in Australia adjusted to suit their own elite private company, corporations, business interests for the elite. Okay, we're using our own private contracts with the king direct, and not with John Key, and whoever gets his authority from is from thin air. He has no queen. I said that already in court with the judge. That's why the police lost the case, because they had no evidence that what I got here on this proclamation document as being the overriding ruling title to this country and those two chiefs. Right? It was preset before the British ships went right around the world and used the same documents, that these native chiefs took stock of all the natives in the world blueprint and took it from Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court. Okay? Got it? That's how it is. Great to say. And to my friends in England, Matt Taylor, he's the leader of the Marae King William Party. Get ready for when I come there with or without Jamie. It's up to her to come or not. But we're going down business. King's business. Okay? And to Jackie, Little Gordon, and Andy in Scotland, up from Balmoral and Glasgow, where the Manukau titles are in the land court there. We're going to check it. Check the authenticity against what I've got here with the Manukau Land Company title from there, and who's on it, whose names are here, and the chiefs here in the Manukau tribal area of Mungatauturi, and with the Hongi Hika, Nga Puhi, Bay of Islands chief, place in history, locked down, and put into our archives here, and the rest of the world, who we are, and where we're going from now on, with our plan. Free passage through the world, under the King's Admiralty Court Martial laws of the sea, and the sky, and the land, and commerce, King of Commerce, titles. So there we are, that's all we need to say for now. We'll catch you later, and I'll get going.